Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: Pakistani authorities have withdrawn terrorism charges against the mastermind of 2008 Mumbai terror attacks, Hafiz Saeed, and his terror group JUD. It also withdrew its request for extending the detention of Saeed under the anti-terrorism law. Saeed and his aides had been kept under house arrest since January 31st. The Indian economy is on a very solid track in the midterm, IMF chief Christine Lagarde has said. Days earlier, the organization had lowered its growth forecast for the current and the next year. She hailed the two major reforms, demonetization and the GST. The government had not spoken about a fiscal stimulus package to boost the economy, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said. He added that the Indian media should be answerable about it. Jaitley had last month reportedly hinted at a package of measures to boost the economy following a sharp drop in the GDP. Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh has said that the country's borders were completely safe and China has also understood that India is no more weak. He added that under the leadership of PM Narendra Modi, India has become a powerful country and its prestige at the international level has grown. Himachal Cabinet Minister Anil Sharma has resigned from the government and the ruling Congress. He joined the opposition BJP along with his father and former Telecom Minister Sukhram. Senior Congress leader and Transport Minister G.S. Pali may also switch sides. An ambitious high-speed train project in South India has been delayed after the Chinese railways that completed a feasibility study a year ago did not respond. Officials claim that the lack of response may be due to the Doklam standoff. At least 26 passengers of the Goa-Mumbai Tejas Express have fallen ill after consuming food served by onboard pantry car operator and have been admitted to the hospital. The IRCTC has launched an investigation. India has issued yet another medical visa to a Pakistani woman seeking an urgent liver transplant. This is the seventh such visa issued by India to Pakistani nationals this month. On Independence Day, New Delhi assured that medical visas will be given to all bona fide Pakistani patients. India has defeated arch foes Pakistan 3-1 to top Pool A in Asia Cup in Dhaka. India will now move into the second round of Super Fours, where the top teams from both the pool will play in round-robin format before the knockouts. Actress Sunny Leone celebrated the birthday of the light of their lives, Nisha Kaur Webber, who she adopted in July. Sunny and her husband Daniel Webber adopted the child from Latur in Maharashtra. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab, Canada and Gujarat follows.